Hi everyone, hope you're doing well and welcome to yet another smashing episode of AIC Retro Toy Museum. First and foremost, I would like to thank all of you who have been watching my videos and following me on Instagram. If you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, please do give a thought and hit that subscribe button and the bell icon. For those who are not yet following me on Instagram, you can go on Instagram and type AICRTM, that stands for AIC Retro Toy Museum, where I regularly post a lot of pics from my collection. So, coming to today's topic, for those who follow me from India, it's going to be a little bit educational, may add a new dimension to what you already knew about G.I. Joe. And of course, from those who are watching me from the United States and abroad, I think it's a very well-known fact. So why is today's video going to be special? I have a very unique MOC figure, which is actually one of the most sought after mint on card G.I. Joe figures. Yes, I'm talking about the 1983 Storm Shadow. This is by far the most sought after figures, and you must know what are the prices of these figures right now. I'm recording this video in 2020. I was checking out the eBay listings that are available for all those Storm Shadow figures that got sold, and they go at a price of at least $1,000 in this condition. Yes, you heard that right. Starting from $1,000 can go up to $2,000-$2,500, which if you convert to Indian rupees can be anywhere between 80,000 to 2 lakh to 2.5 lakh rupees. So what is special about this figure? Obviously, the Storm Shadow is one of the most liked, most sought after characters, and this is the first version of the Storm Shadow that came out. Although the one that I have with me right now has a little bit of a twist, and I am gonna tell you what that is. So I'm sorry if this video appears to be like a clickbait kind of a thing, but that's not the intention, just to show you some one piece of awesomeness that I have. So did I spend more than $1,000 to buy this Storm Shadow figure? Obviously not. I don't have so much money to spend on a freaking action figure. So I found an option which is gives me the same level of joy but at a much lower price. So what I have in hand here is not the original packaging. It is actually a reproduction packaging. So somebody back in the US actually recreated the entire card art which is there on the original Storm Shadow MOC figure, and the figure that I have here is extremely good in condition, and there is a reason why it is so good in condition, because it is not an original. So did I buy a bootleg? People call it a bootleg, some want to call it a custom, some people say it is better than the original. I'll leave that controversy aside. I'm just going to explain you what this is. This is actually a replica Storm Shadow made by a low profile manufacturer, or a guy who calls himself Black Major. So Black Major is famous, or rather infamous, of making an almost exact replica of the original vintage figures, especially the sought after ones which go at crazy prices, and the Black Major ones are much cheaper. So if a figure is costing, let's say, $100-$200, you know, in the open market loose, the Black Major version of that will cost somewhere in the region of $20-$30, depending upon how it is. So whatever little I know about Black Major was, some say that he got access to the original molds, and that's how he or she, I don't know, I think it's a guy, is recreating these G.I. Joes. In fact, the first ones that he made were so close to the original that a lot of people started scamming unsuspecting buyers, telling them that's actually a mint condition figure. But I think during the course of time, like, Black Major continued to make these figures, but they changed the color of, you know, the accessories, or the color of whatever apparel or clothing the G.I. Joe is wearing, so that it becomes very obvious that it's not the original figure, but actually a custom or a replica. So Hasbro's stand on Black Major, I don't think, is very positive, because at some point in time they do feel that, you know, he is eating into their copyright or their business. Although Hasbro as a policy supports creation of customs, that is people who custom paint them, add their own accessories and stuff, or maybe interchange parts, because it is considered to be a part of the hobby. So without further ado, let's just have a look at this figure. It's in a custom star case, as they call it. It is used to keep the MOC figures in great condition. I'm just gonna show you how well the artwork has been recreated. And personally for me, I am not collecting G.I. Joes to become some kind of a big shot collector. I just want to have fun with them. And if somebody is creating a good replica, I'll be very much happy in buying it, as long as it is clearly mentioned that it is a replica. So for instance, if you go towards the back, I don't know if the camera is able to capture it, but the back clearly says that it is reproduction packaging. So just in case, if you are on Facebook or on eBay and see a mint condition Storm Shadow, even if it is selling at $1,000 and it is claimed to be a mint piece, please observe it very, very carefully. There are tons of videos which will explain you what is the difference between a black major and a standard vintage figure. So this figure has all the accessories, has all the all the originality maintained, what is there on the original figure. So there is very little to differentiate from the real deal. And if you look at the card back, again, it is replicating what was there on the original figures card backs as well. And like I said, it's all about the fun of collecting. And that's precisely the reason why, if you had seen my last video, I also got the 2020 Retro Storm Shadow. So so Hasbro did look at this as an opportunity wherein they tried to replicate the original packaging. And you can clearly see the similarities and the differences in both the packagings. So they have tried to retain all the things in terms of the card art, which is very close to the original figure, but there are a lot of changes that have happened in due course of time. So incidentally, this figure has an age limit of 4 and above, whereas this figure has a limit of ages 5 and above. So I'm just comparing them, and like I mentioned in one of my earlier videos, the fact that this figure, which is there in the retro packaging, doesn't look exactly the same like the one which is there on the card art, has actually ruffled a lot of feathers. On the other hand, the figure that you see here is an exact replica of what is there on the card art. Now, so coming to the question, which figure do I like more, the Hasbro Retro series or a Black Major replica? If you ask me personally, this is more of my favorite, because this is something that takes me even further closer to what people would have experienced buying a Storm Shadow in the 18s. Just a quick look at the card backs. Obviously, they have tried to maintain the look and feel of the original card back as much as possible. Unfortunately, in India, you have this import sticker that takes away most of the stuff that's written on the file card, but Indian regulations dictate that every imported toy has this kind of a sticker. But if you look at the content of the file card on the retro style figure, obviously it's far more detailed than what is there on the retro series card back. So this is a short overview of a very special acquisition that I have, and even though it's not an original, it is going to occupy a special place in my collection. Now, coming to the question, if you are into collecting G.I. Joe, should you hunt for something like this, or should you hunt for a retro series? Now, opinions are going to differ, and I respect every opinion that, you know, a person may have about whether one should collect this or that. To be honest, this is far easier to acquire in the current scenario, whereas very few people are actually making this. It is not that easy to get a Black Major figure, especially something like a Storm Shadow in white color. On the top of that, getting it in a reproduction packaging, which is a replica of the original MOC, is even more difficult. So even if you may want to have something like this, it is not easy to get. I just happened to chance upon it, and there are people who are also asking exorbitant prices for this. So I have got it at a very, very low price. It is more expensive. This is more expensive than this, to be honest. But comparing it to what is the actual vintage figure going for, I have got it at a very, very decent price. So this video is talking about what I feel about Black Major and the reproduction packaging that happens. I hope you find something very similar if you really liked it. And till then, do keep on following my channel. I will keep on posting interesting content. If you want to see something interesting that you want to know about, I'll try my best to create content about it. You can write about the same in the comment section, and I'll be definitely reading and replying to each of your comments. If you look at all my videos, I reply to each and every comment, and I will do the same for this as well. So till then, you have a great day, and I hope you enjoy your hobby collecting vintage action figures and toys. And I hope you enjoyed watching this video as well. So till then, goodbye and take care.